Hi, I am Pawan. I will be teaching you science. Today, I will be teaching you 6th standard science first lesson, our food. In this lesson, we are going to learn about different varieties of food and process of making of those foods and preservation of those foods and other things we are going to learn in this lesson. See, first of all, let us get into the topic. If anyone asks you about your favorite food item, what will you answer? The list may include several things like laddu, biryani, idli sambar, pulihora, cheese, dal, etc. But if you are asked about the components or the ingredients and their sources and how they have been cooked, then it may be difficult for you to answer. Generally, we take interest in eating, but we don't bother about other things like preparation of that food and preservation of that food and what are the ingredients required to prepare that food, etc. What for we take food? We take food for health and energy. Health and energy. We take food for health and energy, right? And think about the foods that you eat in your day-to-day life. What are your favorite foods you think of? What are your parents' favorite food you think of? And what are your friends' favorite foods you think of? You just imagine. Children, otherwise, you make a list of your friends and make a list of your relatives and approach them and ask them what are their favorite food items. Here, but we should also know the materials required for preparing the food that we eat. This type of information is very important. So, we will discuss about the ingredients. Ingredients, processing, sources of the food. So these things we will come to know in this lesson. We will learn about all of these things in this lesson in detail. Now you observe the food items pictures displayed on the screen now. Okay, pause the video and observe the pictures displayed on the screen carefully. Yeah, now let us do an activity. Finding variety in our food. What is the activity that we are going to do here? Finding variety in our food. Activity 1. Finding variety in our food. In this activity, yes children, in this activity, what we have to do is, what did you eat yesterday? You just think of and make a list of the food items that you ate yesterday and also discuss with your friends and collect information about what food they had eaten yesterday. Record the information in a table, the table which is displayed on the screen. Okay, this is like a project work. This is like a project work. Now what you have to do is, you have to try to find the answers for the following questions. Are there any common food items in the list of yours and your friends? Obviously, there will be common food items. Yes. And count the number of food varieties you have listed in the table that displayed on the screen. Yes, I hope you have done that. And do all the students eat same type of food items? Obviously, no. What food is served in your school at midday meals? Yes, you have thought different varieties of food items in your midday meals. Yes. We eat different types of food materials daily, but some food items like rice, dal and vegetables are common in our daily menu. Yes, especially in our state we eat rice, dal and vegetables commonly. On special occasions we eat a large variety of food, a large variety of foods. When do we eat a large variety of foods? On special occasions. Yes. Now let us do another activity. The activity is about finding ingredients. The activity is about what? Finding ingredients. See, how do you find ingredients? You know, before finding these ingredients, you should know what is ingredient, what does it mean, what do you understand about ingredients. Ingredients are the things needed to prepare food items. You know, the things needed to prepare food items. This is activity 2. Activity 1 is completed. Now activity 2. In this activity 2, you have to find the ingredients. Many things are needed to prepare a food item. Yes? Many things are needed to prepare food. Yes, here many things I said, right? The things needed to prepare food are called ingredients. You got the point? Yes. For example, there is an example given for you. Srinivas wants to eat something special on Sunday. He asked his mother to make biryani. Srinivas wanted to help his mother. His mother asked him to prepare a list of materials which would be required to make biryani. Srinivas made the list of the things like this. Rice, salt, jeera, list, I said, right? So list should be written in a vertical manner, and tomato, potato, onions, etc. Srinivas made a list like this. If he had missed any material, and complete the list on your own. Srinivas was surprised that while cooking boiled rice, we needed only 2 materials. But why these many materials are required or needed for cooking biryani? He had a question in his mind like that. For cooking boiled rice, we need only 2 things. One is raw rice, and another thing is water. To make different kinds of food, we need different materials that you remember. These materials which are required to prepare food are known as ingredients. Yes? You got this point, right? Now you got this point. What are ingredients? The materials which are required to prepare food are known as ingredients. Now, list out some food items you like to eat and try to find out what ingredients are used to prepare them. You have to do this as a project work on your own. Now, what I am going to do is I am going to give you a table. The table will be displayed on the screen. You draw the table. The table will be with three columns. In one column serial number, and second column food items you like, and third column required ingredients. See children, now what you have to do, you have to identify the ingredients required to prepare some food items. You to try to do in your notebook. See, first food item and ingredients. Number one, the food item like payasam, and second one chicken curry, and third one palli karam. What is that? Palli karam, right? Now what you have to do, you have to write the names of the ingredients that are required to prepare these food items. And then for your better understanding, what you have to do is, you have to get a packet food from any grocery shop, okay, from any other kirana shop like kurkure, and I am not encouraging you to eat this kind of foods, and you will find their ingredients written on their packets. On the surface of the packets, you see something is written on the packet, that things like the things are about ingredients. Have you ever thought from where these ingredients come? Where these ingredients come from? Where these ingredients come from? Yes, it will be easy for you to say that we get vegetables and fruits from plants, and eggs, milk, meat from animals. There is another table that I am going to. Now you can understand the ingredients, and now you can you just find out the sources of the ingredients we get from. Where do we get ingredients from? The sources that you have to think. The sources, like I already told you, like that ingredients come from plants and animals and others. And now I am going to give you a table. You just draw this table, and now in this lesson, table 3. So far we discussed about two tables in this lesson. Now third table I am giving you. Okay, the third table is about ingredients. Who gives us food? With a title, who gives us food? First, you have to draw ingredient. And whether the ingredient comes from plant or animals or others. P stands for plant, A stands for animal, O stands for others. Now if it is plant, you write plant here, right? And then you have to write the name of these are sources of the ingredients. Sources, availability of these ingredients in plants and animals and others. But here in this column, what you have to write? You have to write the name of the source. Okay? You have to fill this table on your own, and you do it as a project work. So then in the next class, I am expecting you all have to fill all the tables given for you and be prepared for the next class. Okay, I hope you all understood this lesson, and then the next class we will discuss further topics and the preservation, making of different food items, and what is vegetable carving and all we will discuss in the next class. This is for today. Thank you for listening. Thank you one and all.